Time for our tale of the tape. This is Canelo Alvarez. He's 172 centimeters tall with a reach of 179. And facing him, Sugar Ray Robinson. Weighed in at an even 147 pounds. He's 5'11". So here is Saul. Neither one of them wants this to go to the judges' scorecards. Left counter was perfectly timed. So much free hype surrounding this fight, the fans are on the edge of their seats.
Situations like this, Todd, will either make or break a fighter because the expectations from the thousands of people here, the millions of people around the world, people like you and I sat here expecting everything and anything can break a man or make a man.
Chins, by the way. Just defend yourself at all times, but this fighter hasn't defended themselves at all. Could go either way. 10 seconds to go. He is down big time on the score.
Looks absolutely exhausted. What are you gonna tell him in the corner?
Prevents that left hook of cutting. At the halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. To keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of these body shots. And that leaves more opportunities for headshots. Score with that left hook. This round's still up for grabs with just 10. puncher is going to wait for you to move first and then will strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy.
To beat a counter, the chance for a striker to have a bad pace. Do not wait for them, because if you wait, they'll pop and pop and all night long. Rush them.
Win. You've got to find it somehow.
Now you've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. Willpower. Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. You get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
What a round so far as we reach the halfway point. And they get out of the way of that left hand. Chin. How strong is your chin? He has a glass chin. These are things that can affect the fight.
Work the body. Frustrate them. Take the mind off the chin. Take the mind off protecting everything around them. Work the body. Use tactics.
season.
Thank you.
correct me if I'm wrong, when you're dealing with someone who's so strong, you've got to get your time in there. It's going to be a fast fight, it's got some speed and footwork. Fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike deep home.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics, they know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Chin. Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Get trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be guessing yourself out trying to get that shot. And that's what it affects you.
He blocks the right uppercut. Get that for just a moment.
How do you deal with it? I think this is the last thing we expected. What a fight. What a style. What a pace to get a unanimous decision. That is mad. This, I didn't see that coming. I thought this would be tight. This is nowhere near tight.
What they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking. Yeah. Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded. Right. What with the Lord, not an omen, still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees, you'd think that it's autumn. Yo, I can't stand these rap boys, still to eliminate all.
That's right.
I'm trying to raise this stack, boy, so tall that it might fall. Top striker, man, I lick off the goal, so anything I set, I achieve and more. Blah. Soon bring the man them on some kind of tour. Yeah. Enough liquor bottles in my rider report. I don't know why they would step to the team, and I'll send man airborne like Fly B. Come like this to some sci-fi scene when I lace this magic on these type of beats. Woo. I don't want to hear no talk from a dweeb. You don't respect me if you don't pay my fees. True. If you don't respect me, then please better back out the way of this heat.
Yeah.
I don't know what they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
Right.
What with the Lord, not an omen, still might have to go.
And all the seats have been sold. We're live at the Empire Fight Camp. And next to me for the broadcast, the one and only Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
It's time now for our tale of the tape. Ricky Hatton, weighing in at 140 pounds, 5 foot 7 inches tall, with a 75-inch reach. And he'll be going up against Sugar Ray Leonard. He has a reach of 70. And Sugar Ray Leonard. They'll be fighting under the lights tonight. What a... Here's the bell for round one. He misses with that jab. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
You can't lose.
potential damage. Let's see if he uses it.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a fucking young man style that he's got. He get inside that long loop. Not many fights can do that.
Someone with the hand speed that this fighter put up. How do you deal with it? A very competitive round. They've got the momentum, they've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Power, punch, perfect.
That was great.
feeling like I got a brand new contract. Armed and dangerous and ready for combat. Soon as I catch him on sight, it's contact. I get the job done proper, there's no comebacks. That's not fair, people hoping on the balance. But either you got that magic or you haven't. And we were born and blessed with all this talent. Soon as we're given a task, it's so apparent. I'm fully prepared, fully activated and ready. Focused on the target, grab my weapon, hold it steady. Your name, you know the name rains heavy. Got the beast in me screaming out, let me out the cage. I ain't got to deal with rage. The days are numbered, see my steps are calculated. On time, not a second hour late. Witnessing the mastery that we display like a hitman. Yeah. See, I go in and get the job done. Experience like I've been doing this for centuries. Before the events I would practice while it was empty. Never needed approval, all I needed was improvement. Got swift with the movement, I attack and defend. We ain't in the same league, we breathe the same air. They act out.
Sold. We're at Brooklyn Hall. I'm Todd Grisham. Next to me, of course, is Johnny Nelson.
I feel like a fraud. How have I got these ringside seats?
It's time for our tale of the tape. It's Ricky Hitman Patton. He weighed in at 140 pounds and will have a 165 centimeter reach. Vasily Lomachenko. This southpaw fighting out of Ukraine is one of the best to ever do it. No one moves. There's only one. Historic venue.
God, I love theaters. For all these reasons, you can hear everybody in the crowd. You can hear the punches. You're fighting coming in, and you know you're in such an intense atmosphere. You know the pressure is going to be on.
What a round so far as we reach the halfway point.
I'm not going to see a lot of
finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
Thank you.
damage. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not clear. Be sharp.
When we talk about a fighter having power, don't just look at the head punches they throw. Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
Power. That power might be the core power. And that power might be the equalizer.
Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
It's gonna be crazy when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You just gotta use brain.
Is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, you'll get back and forth between these two fighters. Looks like this fighter did not work on defense this training camp. Talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
Problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And this is a chin. You can bang too.
Stop. score. Shots that can be the real difference.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. For the practice, they know that second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you? Between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it and back because that's where they're comfortable, or you play calm, play cool.
Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this game.
out of doubt make it look so, so easy.
Rideth every man and woman that cometh into this continent, into this world of America today.
No!
Welcome to the Lighthouse Theater, and here we go, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Hi to everybody back home.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated. And across the ring from him, Tyson Fury. He is a whopping 206 centimeters tall with a reach of 260. Rocky Marciano, 201 pounds of pure terror. This man is an absolute machine. Gentlemen, it is go time. My name is Todd Grisham. Next to me is Johnny Nelson.
You tried to give me the slip, didn't you, my friend? There was no way I was gonna miss this.
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. Sugar Ray Leonard, 5'9" tall with a 70.5-inch reach. There's only one, Ricky Hatton, weighing in at 140 pounds, 5'7" tall with a 75. Sugar Ray Leonard, one of the greatest all-time one world titles in five weight classes. He fights out of Wilmington, North Carolina. Ricky Hatton. What you're seeing as he hits the half of the point of this round. And he just misses with that jab. And he misses with that jab. Nice counter shot. From this guy, he has to bury his forehead in the chest. to be the sweetest sound.
Thank you. don't know what they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
That's right.
War with the Lord, not an omen. Still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees. You'd think that it's autumn. Yo, I can't stand these rap boys, feel to eliminate all.
That's right.
I'm trying to raise this stack, boy, so tall that it might fall.
That's how.
Pop strike arm and I lick off the goal, so anything I set, I achieve and more.
Blah.
Soon bring the man them on some kind of tour. Yeah. Enough liquor bottles in my rider report.
That's
I don't know why they would step to the team. I know seven man airborne like fly beat. Come like this as some sci-fi scene when I lace this magic on these type of beats.
Woo.
I don't want to hear no talk from a dweeb. You don't respect me if you don't pay my fees.
True.
If you don't respect me, then please better back out the way of this heat. I don't know what they thought this was,
what?
But I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
Right.
War with the Lord, not an omen. Still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees. You'd think that it's autumn.
Blah.
I don't know what they thought this was.
Alongside me, English fighting legend Johnny Nelson. It's time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano, the Brockton brawler. This heavyweight is anything but standing only 5'10" tall, 201 pounds. And his opponent, he is Rocky.
We just saw with a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen. He's gonna kick him. He's gonna
sometimes a real victory. That's the mentality here.
How you deal with a slugger, you've got to use brain over ball. Bring in a match ball. Pop, jab, move. Get mind game.
Seconds left. different leagues.
On to the fifth we go. I hate to say that last round was a nightmare. So we can turn it around here.
It was a tough last round. Now you gotta make sure he doesn't put on it. That's what he's gonna find him. Lean on him. Don't get thrown into fire. Not yet. Not to the center of the combat.
This fighter has tested their opponent's power, and the opponent's risen and crashed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
Don't get trigger happy, because all of a sudden he's going to catch himself out trying to get that shot. And that's where he catches him. Fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo? How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you choose is fire with fire. You either give it and back because that's where they're comfortable, or you take down to make pain.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Here's the bell to start round six. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going.
Not clear. Be sharp.
after punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for these cut areas over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them, skin them, go for speed.
Between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this. They are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Having second thoughts in the ring.
I know the scorecards are going to be all over the place with this one.
Combination before you even let one off. That creates frustration, and that's when it gets hard.
fight a little bit closer than I think a lot of people.
Judging this fight is both fighters have got their big moves.
he's going to survive the round here, but just barely. Well, this next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed. To make or break a fighter. The crowd has been waiting for this one for a very long time. Welcome to the CompuBox Academy. I'm Todd Grisham, and watching this live with me is Johnny Nelson.
Looking forward to this one, Todd.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. He'll square off against Smokin' Joe Frazier. Only 6 feet tall even. Muhammad misses with that jab. My personal favorite has to be the Thriller in Manila. It was estimated to have been seen by a billion people, and what a brutal encounter it was.
You've got to get it right. The third time through, Ali had to punch the fire out of his head. Ali was known to say that he's the closest to death he's ever been in the ring. Fraser just had so much. He won't let go, but Ali, he pulled it off again. Fraser gonna do it again for a fourth time? Why? I know why the coaches don't want to do it, the family don't want to do it, but this is this fight, again, this is what our history is made of.
A little bit back and forth between these two fighters. Nice counter shot. He fails to score with that left hand.
So powerful, you just gotta be smart, man. You gotta be like a bit of a favorite.
Close round with 10 seconds to go.
to that jab. Pushing the tempo.
I've seen some aggressive fights. They can terrorize the life out of you before they even throw the shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, that knockout punch. They want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Yeah.
could come out. That's just a day's bit. That's not gonna happen. He's gonna bluff him, man. He's gonna bluff him.
How nervous would you be when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
I've seen certain fighters that can defend just their power alone. Forget tactics, they know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the comedy comes in.
Thank you.
big punch.
Thank you. Nothing in my way will make me be afraid. And I can feel it.
It's a full moon, so look out. We are live outside at Empire Fight Camp. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
Time for our tale of the tape. He is Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated. And he'll be taking on Joe Lewis. He's 6'2" tall, 181 pounds.
The crowd agree, I agree, the ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
Time for the talking to stop and the fighting to start. This should be good. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
It's action night.
It's time for our tale of the tape. He is Smoking Joe Frazier. He took part in the greatest. Right now. over, but he's not back. And with the right hand.
Thank you.
Rollins here in the next one.
Sometimes it can be the sweetest sound. Rounds in one, they're going to be absolutely static.
this fighter's power can change the fight around internationally. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake. I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. It's the doctor's tip. Now you know that Saturday touches. That's where the problem comes from.
Win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
put into this fight. And they come down to that. There's a left hand. And he's about to start round 20. How much is left in their tank after last round?
What a unanimous decision, what a way, what tactics, what a game plan, what a result.